Dear students, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaleyammal Mahalingam Engineering College. I am happy to meet you again through the video lecture series on the subject heat and mass transfer. Today, this is lecture number 105 on conduction heat transfer module. And the topic today for discussion is steady state heat transfer in a cylinder. We recap from the previous lectures. We derived the general heat conduction equation or heat transfer equation in cylindrical coordinate system, and we simplified for different situation. Now, referring to the basic or the general heat conduction heat transfer equation for cylindrical coordinate system, we'll apply to a particular situation. To apply to this situation, steady state heat transfer in a cylinder, and the learning outcome for the students at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to develop the governing equation for one-dimensional steady-state heat transfer in a cylinder without heat generation. So, from the general heat conduction equation, we are going to simplify this equation for one-dimensional steady-state heat transfer in a cylinder without heat generation. And we will solve the equation. At the end, the student will be able to define what is thermal resistance for the cylinder, and the student will be able to solve problems on the composite cylinders. And the general heat conduction equation for cylindrical coordinate system is 1 by r dou by dou r into dou t by dou r plus 1 by r square dou square t by dou phi square plus dou square t by dou z square plus q dot by k equal to 1 by alpha dou t by dou t. So, we recall the terms. R is the radial direction, phi is the asymptotical direction, z is the axial direction, q dot is the rate of heat generation, and k is the thermal conductivity of the cylinder material, alpha is the thermal diffusivity of the cylinder material. And we will simplify the equation for the specific condition, one-dimensional steady-state heat transfer in a cylinder without heat generation. So, for one-dimensional, these two terms are dropped. So, we consider only the heat transfer in the radial direction. So, the heat transfer in the asymptotical direction or the temperature variation in the axial direction, they are dropped. And without heat generation, so Q dot term becomes zero. And the steady-state heat transfer, so the temperature variation with respect to time is equal to zero. So removing all the term, finally the governing equation for this situation, one dimensional steady state heat transfer in a cylinder without heat generation, this is 1 by r dou by dou r into dou t by dou r equal to zero. Now we consider a hollow cylinder of inner radius r1, outer radius r2. The inner surface temperature is T1 and outer surface temperature is T2. Now the boundary conditions are T equal to T1 at R equal to R1 and T equal to T2 at R equal to R2. So we have to solve this governing equation within the boundary conditions to get the solution for one-dimensional steady-state heat transfer in a cylinder without heat generation. And we take the equation integrating. The equation is 1 by r dou by dou r into dou t by dou r equal to 0. You take r to the right side. So, 1 dou by dou r into dou t by dou r equal to 0. Integrating first time. So, you will get r into dou t by dou r equal to c1. Rearranging, take the r to the right side. So, dou t by dou r equal to c1 by r. Now, integrating again, t equal to c1. Integrating 1 by r logarithmic of r plus c2. So, there are two constants C1 and C2. We require two boundary conditions to find the solutions. And recall the boundary conditions T equal to T1 at R equal to R1 and T equal to T2 at R equal to R2. Now, we substitute the boundary conditions in the temperature equation and we will get the value. So, T1 equal to C1 logarithmic of R1 plus C2 and T2 equal to C1 logarithmic of R2 plus C2. And you take, subtract the equation 1 minus equation 2. So, T1 minus T2 on the right side. So, the entire term, it is C1 into logarithmic of R1 minus R2, C2 is getting cancelled. So we will write as C1 into logarithmic of R1 by R2. From here, C1 equal to T1 minus T2 divided by logarithmic of R1 by R2. Now we substitute the C1 value in the first equation. So from here, first equation, C2 equal to T1 minus C1 into logarithmic of R1. And substituting for C1, C2 equal to T1 minus T1 minus T2 divided by logarithmic of R1 by R2 into logarithmic of R1. So we got the value of C1 here and C2 here. Now we substitute C1, C2 in this equation, temperature equation, we will get the temperature distribution. So temperature distribution T equal to C1 logarithmic of R plus C2. So substituting for C1 and C2. So T equal to C1 is T1 minus T2 divided by logarithmic of R1 by R2 into logarithmic of R plus C2 equal to T1 minus T1 minus T2 divided by logarithmic of R1 by R2 into logarithmic of R1. Now here we take T1 to the left side, this becomes T minus T1, and we have the first term and the third term. We write the first and the third term, so T1 minus T2 divided by logarithmic of R1 by R2 into log R minus T1 minus T2 divided by logarithmic of R1 by R2 into logarithmic of R1. So combining, we will get T1 minus T2 divided by logarithmic of R1 by R2 multiplied by logarithmic of R minus logarithmic of R1. So this equal to T1 minus T2, T minus T1 equal to T1 minus T2 divided by logarithmic of R1 by R2 into, so this term will become logarithmic of R by R1. So finally, the temperature distribution is T minus T1 divided by T1 minus T2 equal to logarithmic of R by R1 divided by logarithmic of R1 by R2. So using this equation, we can calculate the temperature T for any given radius R within R1 and R2. So the lower value of R equal to R1, the upper value of R equal to R2. So within this range, we can find the temperature. That is what the significance or use of the temperature distribution equation. Then we calculate the rate of heat transfer. So from the Fourier law of heat conduction, Q equal to minus Ka into dT by dr, and we have to calculate the value at R equal to R2. So the heat is transferred from the inner radius to the outer radius. So we calculate at R equal to R2. So at R equal to R2, dT by dr equal to C1 by R2. So we substitute minus Ka into C1 by R2. So 1 by R2 into T1 minus T2 divided by logarithmic of R1 by R2, where this area equal to surface area on the outer radius, which is 2 pi R2 into L. So substituting all the values, R2 is getting cancelled. So what is left out? Minus 2 pi KL into T1 minus T2 divided by logarithmic of R1 by R2. So to drop the negative sign here, we change the direction, the denominator. So Q equal to 2 pi KL into T1 minus T2 divided by logarithmic of R2 by R1. So this is what the amount of heat transfer in the case of a cylinder, one dimensional heat transfer in a cylinder without heat generation. Now the rate of heat transfer, we write, rearrange. So Q equal to T1 minus T2. I take the 2 pi KL to the denominator. So 1 by 2 pi KL into logarithmic of R2 by R1. Now we take the concept of electrical analogy. So what we discussed earlier for this lab. So we have a cylinder of inner radius R1, outer radius R2, inner surface temperature T1, outer surface temperature T2, and the heat is transferred from the inner surface to outer surface. So T1 minus T2 divided by the resistance. So the thermal resistance for the cylinder, using the electrical analogy, the thermal resistance for the cylinder is 1 by 2 pi KL logarithmic of R2 by R1. So the important equation is the heat transfer for the cylinder and the thermal resistance for the cylinder. These two are important, and you carefully note it down wherever the point is required, and repeatedly you have to remember for solving the problem. And if you take a composite cylinder, two layers of cylinder, so the corresponding thermal circuit. So I have the first cylinder, inner cylinder R1, outer cylinder R2, and third cylinder R3. So this is the first layer of the material. This is another layer of the material. There are two composite cylinders. So T1, T2, and T3. Resistance offered by the first layer is R1. Resistance offered by the second layer is R2. The value of the resistance are 1 by 2 pi k1 into L into logarithmic of R2 by R1 and R2 equal to 1 by 2 pi k2 into L into logarithmic of R3 by R2. So the k1, k2 are the thermal conductivity of the material, composite cylinder. So this k for the first cylinder, k1 is thermal conductivity, and for the second cylinder, k2 is the thermal conductivity. And the rate of heat transfer, we can calculate q equal to T1 minus T3 divided by R1 plus R2, and the intermediate temperature or the interface temperature, it may be calculated from this equation. Q equal to T1 minus T2 divided by R1, which is equal to T2 minus T3 divided by R2. So, the composite cylinder, the concept of composite cylinder will be using for solving the problem. So, we have to remember the thermal resistance equation for the cylinder, and you can apply to any number of composite layers. And a hollow cylinder with the convection on both sides. So we have a hollow cylinder, inner radius R1, outer radius R2, and we have some hot fluid flowing inside. So this is very popular example for a superheated tube, economizer tube, air purificated tube. Hot fluid is flowing inside, cold fluid is flowing outside. Now the heat is transferred across the metal wall. So the first resistance is the convection due to the hot fluid, second resistance due to the metal wall, conduction due to the metal wall, and third resistance for the heat transfer, the resistance for the convective heat transfer on the outside. So the convection resistance is H into A, where inner area is 2 pi R1 into L, and we know the conduction resistance 1 by 2 pi K L into logarithmic of R2 by R1, and the convection resistance on the outside H2 into A, where A equal to 2 pi R2 into L. And here the rate of heat transfer equal to T infinity 1, the terminal temperature is T infinity 1 minus T infinity 2, divided by Ri plus R, R plus RO, and the intermediate temperature, we can use the equation Q equal to T infinity 1 minus T1 divided by Ri equal to T1 minus T2 divided by R equal to T2 minus T infinity 2 divided by RO. And we will stop here. We will have a reflection spot. We just recall the portion what we discussed for the past 12 minutes and try to answer this question. Write the equation for one-dimensional steady-state heat transfer in a cylinder without heat generation. Take a moment and write the answer. So, if your answer is this, the governing equation for one-dimensional steady-state heat transfer in a cylinder. So, 1 by R, dou by dou R into dou T by dou R equal to 0. And another question. Write the thermal resistance equation for a cylinder. So, you take a moment and write the answer. And if your answer is this, R thermal, thermal resistance for the cylinder equal to 1 by 2 pi KL into logarithmic of R2 by R1. So, if your answers are correct, you are good. And we take up your problem now. Example 1. This is from the Anna University question paper. Steam at 320 degrees Celsius flows in a cast iron pipe of thermal conductivity 80 watts per meter Kelvin, whose inner and the outer diameter are 5 cm and 5.5 cm respectively. The pipe is covered with 3 cm thick glass wool insulation with thermal conductivity of 0.05 watts per meter Kelvin. The heat lost to the surrounding at 5 degrees Celsius by natural convection. Natural convection radiation with combined heat transfer coefficient 18 watts per meter square Kelvin. Taking the heat transfer coefficient inside the pipe as 60 watts per meter square Kelvin, determine the rate of heat loss from the steam per unit length of the pipe. Also determine the temperature drop across the pipe shell and the insulation. And this is the configuration, diagrammatic representation of the problem. We have steam flowing inside the pipeline, the atmospheric air on the outside of the pipeline. We have the first layer of metal of inner radius R1, outer radius R2, the second layer of insulation of radius R2 and R3. So, K1 is the thermal conductivity of the pipe material and K2 is the thermal conductivity of the insulating material. So, the data given. Inner radius of the cylinder R1 equal to 0.025 meter, 5 centimeter is given, 0.025 meter. R2 equal to 5.5 centimeters given, 0.0275 meter, and R3 equal to 0.0575 meter because 3 centimeter thickness of insulation is added. So 0.0575 millimeter. And the thermal conductivity of the pipe material is 80 watts per meter Kelvin and thermal conductivity of the insulation is 0.05 watts per meter Kelvin. The inside heat transfer coefficient is 60 watts per meter square Kelvin and the temperature is 320 degrees Celsius. The outside heat transfer coefficient is 18 watts per meter square Kelvin and the temperature is 5 degrees Celsius. And this is what the thermal circuit. TA is the steam temperature. RI is the resistance, convection resistance due to the seam. R1 is the resistance due to this pipe material. R2 is the resistance due to the insulating material. And RO is the resistance due to the air or the surrounding. TO is the surrounding temperature. So we read the problem and clearly represent the problem in the form of a diagram and draw the thermal circuit and write down the given data that indicates you understood the problem statement correctly. So once you have the clear data about the problem, then you can easily solve the problem. So we calculate various thermal resistances. So Ri equal to 1 by 2 pi R1 into L. So area is 1 by 2 pi R1 into L into Hi, which is 1 by 2 pi into 0.025 into 1 into 60 equal to 0.106 Kelvin by watt. And R1 is the pipe material, resistance due to the pipe material, 1 by 2 pi K1 into L into logarithmic of R2 by R1 equal to 1 by 2 pi 80 into 1 into logarithmic of 0.0275 divided by 0.0525 equal to 1.897 10 power minus 4 Kelvin by watt. And the resistance due to the insulation R2 equal to 1 by 2 pi K2 into L logarithmic of R3 by R2 equal to 1 by 2 pi into 0.05 into 1 into logarithmic of 0.0575 divided by 0.0275 equal to 2.349 Kelvin by watt. And the resistance due to the outside convection RO equal to 1 by 2 pi R3 L into HO, which is 1 by 1 over 2 pi into 0.0575 into 1 into 18, which is 0.154 Kelvin by watts. So use the calculator and you can even verify the values or just listen to it and later on you solve the problem, check your answer with the answer given here in the solution. Now the rate of heat transfer, Q equal to the terminal temperatures Ti minus To divided by sum of all the resistances Ri plus R1 plus R2 plus RO. So substitute the values 0.106 plus 1.897 in 10 power minus 4, 2.349 plus 0.154. So the heat transfer is 120.72 watts. The rate of heat transfer equal to 120.72 watts. And temperature drop across the pipeline. So Q into R1 equal to 120.72 into 1.897 10 power minus 4, which is 0.0229 Kelvin. And temperature drop across the insulation. Q into R2 equal to 120.72 into 2.349, which is 283.57 Kelvin. So the answer for the problem, rate of heat transfer equal to 120.72 watts and temperature drop in the pipeline equal to 0.0229 Kelvin and temperature drop in the insulation is 283.57 Kelvin. We take another problem. Example number 2, this is also from analysis question paper November 2016. A steel pipe with 550 mm OD outside diameter is covered with two layers of insulation. The inner layer is 7.5 mm thickness and has a thermal conductivity of 0.3 watts per meter Kelvin. And the top layer is 20 mm thick with a thermal conductivity of 0.12 watts per meter Kelvin. The pipe wall is at 350 degrees Celsius and the outside air temperature is 25 degrees Celsius. Determine the surface temperature and the heat loss per meter length of pipe for 10 minutes. Take the convective heat transfer coefficient between the air and the surface as 16 watts per meter square Kelvin. So this is the diagram, the diagrammatic representation. First layer is the steel pipe. First layer is the insulation, second layer is the second insulation, and we have the R1 is the resistance due to the first layer of insulation, R2 is the resistance due to the second layer of insulation, and RO is the resistance due to the air, and T1 is the temperature here, and TO is the temperature of the air. And the given data, the outer radius of the pipe, R1 equal to 0.025 meter, R2 is, you have to add 7.5 millimeter thickness. So this is 7.5 millimeter thickness is equal to 0.0325 meter, and R3 equal to 0.0525 meter. So thermal conductivity of the first insulating material is 0.3 watts per meter Kelvin, and second insulating material is 0.12 watts per meter Kelvin. The surface temperature, inner surface temperature of the pipe is 350 degrees Celsius, and the air temperature is 25 degrees Celsius, and the heat transfer coefficient is 16 watts per meter square Kelvin. The time is 10 minutes and length of the pipe equal to 1 meter. So the resistances, R1 equal to 1 by 2 pi Ka1 into L logarithmic of R2 by R1, which is 1 by 2 pi into K1 equal to 0.3, length equal to 1 meter, logarithmic of 0.0325 divided by 0.025, which is 0.139 Kelvin by watts. And R2 equal to 1 by 2 pi K2 into L logarithmic of R3 by R2, which is 1 by 2 pi into 0.12 into 1 logarithmic of 0.0525 divided by 0.0325, which is 0.636 Kelvin by watts. And the resistance due to the outside air, RO equal to 1 by area into HO, 2 pi R3 into L into HO, which is 1 by 2 pi into 0.0525 into 1 into 16, which is 0.189 Kelvin by watts. So all these calculations, you have to carefully use the calculator and solve numerically. And rate of heat transfer equal to Q equal to T1 minus TO divided by R1 plus R2 plus RO, which is 315 minus 25 divided by 0.139 plus 0.636 plus 0.189 equal to 300.8 watts. So it is joules per second. So for heat transfer for 10 minutes, so Q equal to 300.8 into 10 into 60 equal to 180.83 kilojoules. And the surface temperature, T2 equal to, so from this equation, Q equal to T1 minus T2 divided by the corresponding resistance. So T2 equal to T1 minus QR1. So T2 equal to 315 minus 300.8 into 0.139, which is 273.2 degree Celsius. And Q equal to T3 minus T2 will be R2 equal to, from this equation, T3 equal to T2 minus Q into R2, which is T3 equal to 273.2 minus 300.8 into 0.636, which is equal to 81.89 degree Celsius. And the answers for the problem are, heat transfer equal Q equal to 180.83 kilojoules, and intermediate temperature T2 equal to 273.2 degree Celsius and 81.89 degree Celsius. And these are the reference book I referred for preparing the notes. So you can refer to it for further information. And I have published this book on the subject heat and mass transfer. You can refer to it for additional problems. And if you have any queries, you can write to me to my mail ID. I will sincerely answer all your queries. So thank you. We'll meet again.